Drivers who switch and save with Progressive save over $700 on average, and those savings add up. Imagine what you could buy in the future.
So I used the savings from switching to Progressive 30 years ago to buy tickets to the championship game. You know, between those two teams that didn't exist 30 years ago. Yeah, I'm a big Alaska Palm Trees fan. Which is a team now? In the future?
So switch to Progressive and save big, because those savings can add up in the future. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. National annual average insurance savings by new customer surveyed who saved with Progressive in 2020. Potential savings will vary.
Hurry in to Mattress Firm's July 4th sale. Get a king bed for the price of a queen or a queen for a twin and save up to $500 on Sealy. Plus, get a free adjustable base with qualifying Sealy purchase up to a $499 value. Or shop Tempur-Pedic, the most highly recommended bed in America, and save $500 on all Tempur-Breeze mattresses. And get a $300 instant gift good towards sleep accessories. Only at Mattress Firm. Restrictions apply. See store or mattressfirm.com for details.
What up, friends? I've got another free view of the Lost Zane recordings from my time on 107.3 WBBL. All right. Now, in this free view, it was part of a week-long Stu McAllister sit-in with your old pal Eric Zane. All right. It was, just before New Year's, 2016 into 2017. It's like an audio time capsule from my days with my own show on the radio before it all came crashing down. Anyway, I'd like to give you one segment of the Lost Zane recordings right here, and then the full show is available on my Patreon, patreon.com/Eric Zane. That is where I've basically camped out for the past 3.5 years. Patreon.com/Eric Zane. Free content. I always appreciate you supporting me by listening to it, but if you really want to help out the show, sign up for my Patreon with a $5 or $10 donation per month, or whatever you want to donate per month. It's up to you. I've got it set at $5 for all of the audio, $10 for all the audio, and all of the video. I say donation because it is, and I'd like to give you a lot in return for you digging into your pocket. And what a kind gesture to throw it my way to keep the lights on and keep the puppy dogs fed. Patreon.com/Eric Zane. Thank you so much. If not, enjoy this, and we'll talk to you down the road. Bye-bye.
And yes, we are back. December 30th, it's the Eric Zane Show, show number 181. The last show of 2016, just like that, under our belt. Weather today, you'll see a little bit of snow here and there, lake effect kind of, making things interesting. And that was a lot of what happened in the back half of the day yesterday, making the roads not very good at all. It feels like 16 outside, but it's 28 with a 17-mile-an-hour wind. A little bit high of 29 today, and a little bit warmer for Saturday with a high of about 35, maybe some snow. Welcome in. One Stuart Reeves McAllister.
I like how you leave my middle name in. Thanks.
Well, it's a damn great name. It's sure. Reeves.
Reeves, baby. With an I.
So I'll meet somebody new today, and I'll be like, hey, I know a guy with a middle name of Reeves. Just work it in there at any one point.
They'll be like, all right, moving on.
So, it's very normal to take a nap every day. I am in a unbelievable winning streak of naps. And I know, and I say that, you may get jealous, Stu, because you have a second job, for God's sake.
Yeah, I leave here and I go to that.
Yeah, I mean, just to think that after getting up way too early and then going to do a job, it's just, well, it sounds terrible.
It's life.
It's the same thing today?
Yeah.
Do you get to go home at all, let the dog out?
Yeah, today I'm home for like maybe a half hour. So I go home, let the dog out. Yeah, I know. It's all right, man.
Well,
it's life.
You know, I mean, I think we can add that to the legend that is Stu, the fact that he would come in here and support the show and do this in like a moonlighting scenario like it has been for the past, since last Friday.
Yep.
So it is appreciated. Thank you.
Thank you.
But I crashed, and I took this absurd nap, and it's hard to describe it, but I know I kept waking up during this. I don't know. I basically went back to bed. Yeah, but I didn't intend to. But I couldn't come out of the sleep. So I would awaken, and my eyes would open. I remember looking at the clock. I remember seeing it was snowing out. I remember things in the room.
Okay.
But this was all the while I'm dreaming.
Oh, one of those creepy.
So the dream would go on, and then I would start to come out of it, but then I would shut it back down again, and the dream would remain. And I think there is actually like a hard reset button on the dream computer on your brain that you actually have to get up and go, well, I'm up now, I am awake, and I will not have another dream. Yep. You actually have to get up, out, walk around, you know, put water on your face.
Snap out of it.
So then I almost was, I was pretty much like trying to see how I could keep doing this. It was almost like I was playing a game. I was entertaining myself.
You were in control,
while
baby.
I was asleep, and I was like, I think I'll come out of it, and I'll go back in. But the thing is, this was not a good dream. It was very, very strange. And the dream was I had gotten out of, I had lost this job, and I went back to the Tri-City, Saginaw, Bay City, Midland, where I first really started to cut my teeth in this deal.
Nice.
And I went back to an old radio station and started to work there. And I went to my old neighborhood in Midland and bought the house that I used to own, which that is neat to me.
You're going into the past.
I know.
What are you doing?
I know. And it was weird. In the dream, I banged on the door of the neighbor who I used to know to see if he still lived there. And a woman answered the door who I didn't recognize and said, hey, does Mike live here? This is in the dream. She goes, no. And she slammed the door in my face. And I was like, and I pounded on the door again, and then I'm waiting for her to answer it. And I thought, oh, God. In the dream, I'm like, oh, boy, she's probably going to shoot me now.
Right.
I forget what happened at that point.
Right.
I then remember interactions with people I don't recognize. And then I remember one of the new neighbors offering me beer. And I don't drink, as you know. I can't drink. I mean, I'm an alcoholic, for God's sake. Yeah. And in the dream, I drank. Now, this has happened. Have you ever heard, in your social work background, you ever heard about anything like this? I mean, this is drinking dreams and alcoholics is a pretty regular thing.
Yeah.
And what happens, and this has been going on for over 20 years for me, you have these dreams, and you are convinced you have actually drank.
Oh.
You feel bad, and in the dream...
Shame.
In the dream, I'm like, oh, no, my wife is going to smell it. She's going to kill me. And in the dream, I'm like freaking out.
Yeah.
And I've now convinced myself that it is legit. And I have had moments in time where then you wake up from the dream and it's like, oh, it was all a dream. But they are so tangible and profound that a small part of me, for long stretches of time, thinks that I have fallen off the wagon at some point. I have started to have to go while I'm awake.
Yeah.
Like sitting here talking to you going, now, have I actually fallen off the wagon ever? And then I realized, no, you have not. Mm-hmm. You have not done that. Now, some people may. I mean, whatever. Everybody's different. But, man.
Your brain was messing with you yesterday.
That is just the weirdest thing.
Yeah.
Oh,
did it seem weirder? Because it sounded, when you started off, you were in control of these dreams.
And that does happen. Lucid dreams. Yeah. I have those, too. Yeah. And it usually results in me boning someone.
I sense it.
All right. A word for FitBod, which is an app that is going to help you get in shape, stay in shape, help you to live longer, avoid injury, be more durable, and just overall improve your quality of life and your health. Believe me, I know what it's like to start and stop exercise programs. The FitBod app, though, is helping me stay motivated. There's no question that my overall strength being improved because of the FitBod app is going to help me destroy Mike Ball in the Grand Rapids Half Marathon coming up in October. At the end of this, I'm going to tell you how to take advantage of the FitBod app. After you download the FitBot app and you put your information about your age, your weight, your fitness goals, things like that, it's going to tailor specific workouts for each of your body parts for each days of the week. It's a fantastic way to track what you're doing and stay on top of it and keep you motivated. That's what I love so much about this. Basically, they take the guesswork out of what you're supposed to be doing. Gone are the days when you just march into the gym and start slinging around weights and hope that something works out. What's going to happen to you there is you're going to lose motivation because you're not going to see any results, or worse, you're going to get hurt. Tapping into the FitBot app is going to help you achieve your goals. And trust me, after you start seeing the results of all the hard work you're putting in, you're going to stay motivated. That's the key. And with FitBot guiding you every step of the way, that's going to happen sooner rather than later. It's time to quit talking and finally start doing something. Hey, I'm right there with you. I've eaten myself out of shape and I'd like to get back into shape. The FitBot app is going to help me do that. Let's get motivated and do it together. You can build your fitness habit and become a better version of yourself with FitBot. And how about this? You get 25% off your subscription or try out the app for free when you sign up now at fitbod.me/Zane. So let me say that all again, okay? You go to fitbod.me/Zane and you can try the app for free. You can also get 25% off of your subscription when you do that. fitbod.me/Zane. 25% off when you sign up today at fitbod.me/Zane. Zane. Okay, you know, losing fitness, gaining weight, that all hurts a person mentally. Honest to God, that can affect your relationships. It's time to turn this thing around. I want to help you feel better. And all you have to do is decide that you want to try. I want you to try this as you're trying to turn things around. It's the FitBod app. This thing is amazing. You don't need a ton of weights to do this. You can do it in your home with no weights. You can do it in the middle of nowhere like I do at Fear Bunker North. You can do it at the gym. The workouts are tailored to what you have to work with. And my gosh, they work everything. Muscles, cardiovascular system, you name it. It's time to turn it around, and I want you to do it by using the FitBod app. One of the important things about FitBod is the algorithm changes, which, you know, those are words that's kind of like above my pay grade, but it senses and knows when you're improving as you work out and updates your fitness plan as you go so that you're not like stagnating and things like that and plateauing. FitBod has figured it out, and all you have to do, for less than the cost of one session with a personal trainer, you can get a full year of personalized workouts with FitBod. It integrates with your Apple Watch, Wear OS smartwatch, and apps like Apple Health, Fitbit, and Strava. Man, this is incredible. You can crush your summer fitness goals with personalized workouts from FitBod that improve as you do. Get 25% off your subscription or try out the app for free when you sign up now at fitbod.me/Zane. It's got to be fitbod.me/Zane. Try it out and see for yourself. 25% off your subscription or try it free at fitbod.me/Zane. FitBod.
Theme. How long were you out for on this nap?
Let's see. About 2 hours and 20 minutes.
Oh, that was pretty long, man.
Yeah, I basically went back to bed.
All right, how'd you feel when you got up? Disoriented?
Yeah, and I did not. I had trouble actually waking up. I was a mess. My heart was beating at like 50 beats a minute. Mm. I was like, oh God, I can't get going. I had to go to the gym and swim, and then I came out of it finally. But great. Man, oh,
right,
terrible. I even tweeted it out. I go, unbelievable. Woke up scared. I have two recurring dreams: the drinking dream and losing my teeth dream.
Regular. Losing your teeth.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I know.
You had a busted mouth.
People have said to me, you know, it means something. And in fact, I'll get emails after throwing it out on the air right now. People saying this is what it means. It's like, I don't know if it means.
You talk for a living, so I mean, that would be an awful thing to lose your teeth.
Well, Gravy from Hot FM, he often, because he found this out, and he was, but what that means is that you're talking crap about someone.
What?
Like, well, yeah, I don't know, maybe. And then he keeps telling me, so I think he's trying to indicate that he thinks that I've been talking about him, which is true. So maybe he's onto something.
That's like when your ear gets hot and people are like, I mean, someone's talking about you. Yeah. No, it doesn't.
No, it just means my ears are warm.
Yeah. Stupid.
Completely different subject. I haven't really been too in depth with the whole Russian hacking thing. I mean, I've been aware of it.
Yeah.
But I have some questions about the whole thing because the president now has imposed sanctions on what his intelligence has learned about people in Russia hacking the United States in an attempt to, as it's been charged, and I don't know if this is for sure, swing the election so that Donald Trump would be president. Am I getting what?
Yes.
As far as you have read, does that sound that about
is,
right?
That is correct from
and,
what I know.
And now I am hearing that the president has, there's been some diplomats that are in the United States that are Russians that he has made them, they had like 72 hours to leave the country along with their families, like kicking them out of the country.
Ramping it up, huh?
And other various things to punish Russia.
Yeah.
And then the Russians have said, well, we will measure our response, which means they're thinking about it. Mm-hmm. So this is, it sounds pretty messy.
Yes. You
know? And, but what, I thought to myself, well, now what do you park on here? What do you talk about? What do you get into it other than just spewing what everybody else has thrown out there, and that is the details of these indictments and the response. And I guess what I can honestly do is just throw out what could the motive have been, because it could be funny if you think about it. If, let's just say in this hypothetical situation, Russia said, all right, comrades, let's hack them to get Mr. Trump elected.
Yeah.
This is just hypothetical.
Sure.
Three things. One, did they do it because they think that they would be better off, Russia, with Donald Trump as the president?
Uh-huh.
Or did they do it because they thought America would be worse off with Donald Trump? I'm not being a snark idiot. I'm just asking the question.
Yep.
And the third thing, if they did do that and, in fact, were successful in getting him elected, in this hypothetical, if he was elected because the Russians hacked us.
Right.
If you are a supporter of Donald Trump, do you love Russia now because of this? I mean, if it comes out that he would have lost the election had Russia not been involved, and you are a Trump supporter, are you going, well, hell yeah, I love Russia.
Because I'm a commie.
Well, maybe not that, but because their guy got elected. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And so now they... You know, I don't know.
I'm still confused as to, even if the Russians did hack into whatever, like, what information? Was it, like, all the bad information about Hillary that got released?
Yeah, the term hacked is a very general term these days.
And I
have no idea if this means, that, like you said, they found out information and then spread propaganda or information that, well, it may have been true.
Right.
Or did they... Or because I have a very pedestrian knowledge of this entire story, and I like it that way, frankly.
Sometimes it's better that way.
Yeah.
Ignorance is bliss.
Uh-huh. Or are they talking about they actually had their fingers in it? Like, okay, Trump had one vote, now he has 1,000 votes.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
right. Yeah, I don't think it was that. I'd like to believe it wasn't.
There's
that.
No way. It couldn't have been.
Man, that. No. Please, no.
It can't be that easy.
Sure.
For just a handful of bright minds in another country to swing an election.
Obama doing these sanctions, is he saying that he believes the Russian government is responsible for these hacks? Or just a bunch of, like, computer nerds having fun?
I don't I don't know if he's come out and said that. I haven't read that, but maybe.
All right. Because what does he think? What is the Russian government going to do if it's a bunch of 400-pound dudes in their basement having fun on their computer? Like, what does he expect the Russian government to do? Right?
He has to think that the government was behind it, right? If he's kicking diplomats out of the country?
That's what I would take away from it. But it just seems weird to me that you think an actual government is going, let's mess with these guys in their election process.
And to what end? Because now the saber rattling, all this is done, is now everybody's kind of like on this heightened sensitivity. And, you know, everybody's got nuclear weapons these days. And it was never good back when they were. So I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm just throwing those things out there.
It's creepy, man. It scares me. It's like that Cold War nonsense again coming back, possibly.
Right, right.
Who wants that?
Mm. A lot of fun things in store today. We have tickets to give away. We've got Jenny Garone from Celebration Cinema is going to come in.
She's a favorite.
And she's coming in here. No one was scheduled to be here from them today.
Okay.
But she wanted to play Stump Jenny. Now, normally, we kicked off last week the Stump Ron movie trivia game. And Ron sucked. He was so bad at it.
Wow, I thought he would have been super knowledgeable.
Oh, no. Well, that's the thing. I mean, the guy's worked in the movie industry
50 years.
In a really crazy amount. I think it might be 40.
Yeah, it's a lot more than you would think.
And they asked him a question. The audience would ask him questions like, what was the hit movie in the 1970s about a shark? Mm-hmm. Four letters in the title took place in New York.
Start with the letter J.
And he'd be like, I don't know.
It's a tough one.
So Jenny says, well, I can do a hell of a lot better than him.
All right. Probably. She's hip. I moved her out of her house.
Like, you like threw her out of her house or you?
No, I helped her move. She moved from point A to point B and I helped her move.
Oh, okay.
And I didn't know who she was. I was part of a moving company that helped move her.
Oh.
Because the last time I was here and she was here, she stopped me and said, yeah, you moved me out of my house. And I was like, what, is I a D to you in any way? And she's like, no, you were all right.
You are right. Yeah.
I had to make sure. So
you were when I was in here and that interaction took place?
Yeah. No, you weren't. This was like off air.
Oh, okay.
Because I didn't recognize her or anything, but she recognized me.
Oh,
it was kind of weird.
Oh, yeah. She remembered you.
How funny is that?
How about that?
Mm-hmm.
There's hope.
Yeah.
but in just a few short minutes, actually at 6:22, I had an awkward interaction at the YMCA with the very young lifeguards, two young ladies yesterday.
All right, what happened?
I'll tell you about it coming up in just a bit. It was awkward. I thought one thing, and then I felt stupid. I felt really stupid.
Was this an age thing?
No, but I really thought that I was something special for a brief moment in time, and then that changed dramatically because of something on my body.
Oh.
Okay? 6:22, I'll tell you that story. And if anyone asks you who you listen to, please tell them the Eric Zane Show on 107.3 WBBL.
That's it. My preview, or FREEview, of the Lost Zane recordings. Full show, patreon.com/Eric Zane. Have a good one, folks. Bye-bye.
Drivers who switch and save with Progressive save over $700 on average, and those savings add up. Imagine what you could buy in the future.
Hey, remember how 20 years ago I switched to Progressive? Well, now it's the future, and I used all those savings to buy this new hologram phone. Because, you know, it's the future, and everything is holograms now.
So switch to Progressive and save big, because those savings can add up in the future. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. National annual average insurance savings by new customer surveyed who saved with Progressive in 2020. Potential savings will vary.